Mother Mary would like to just speak briefly or share briefly through me about a very important subject, and that is emotional intelligence. And she says that the more we develop our hearts in love of God and in devotion to the One, the greater our emotional intelligence will be. We strengthen our hearts through this love and devotion. We expand our hearts through this love and devotion. We soften our hearts through love and devotion, so that our hearts are beating in unison with, in synchronicity with God. And when our hearts are developed to a higher initiatic state where we can feel deeply the abiding presence of our God Self, the omnipresence that's vouchsafed to us as a part of the Holy Spirit's magnanimous universal presence, then we naturally rise into that state where we utilize this love in kind words and respectful thoughts and deep consideration of everyone and everything and every moment, so that we bring emotional intelligence as a divine equation into our life. So what does this mean? It means that we're less reactive if things seem to go wrong, or we're ready to say something to someone that could be hurtful or maybe misrepresent what we truly feel inside by the ego nature. So when we are in divine emotional intelligence, we are in that sacred space where we, being careful and christic in both our thoughts and feelings, and especially our feelings and emotions, are more reticent to misqualify energy, to say things that could be spiteful or hurtful or demeaning or debasing to others. Mother Mary says that mankind en masse require greater emotional intelligence if we are to rise into that vibration and consciousness whereby we can bring in the great golden crystal age of Aquarius. So this is one of the keynotes for planetary salvation and elevation and salvation, is that we all develop and choose to develop our emotional intelligence and to utilize all the resources, the toolkits, the spiritual toolkits that we have, or the tools within our toolkits, to maintain that harmony, that equanimity, that constancy on the path, where there is not this interruptive state of highs and lows in our vibration, where we are jagged in our auric field, where we get upset and we misqualify energy and we just, this person did this to me, and therefore I've got to react and I've got to respond and I've got to, you know, I just don't understand them and blah, blah, blah. So when we are in the state of our Christic presence and the harmonics of our divine essence, there's a smoothness to our vibration and our auric field where we do have this emotional intelligence. So initiates, even myself, we at times become reactive. We may get frustrated that we're not doing things quite at the level that we'd like. We feel that we're not good enough, or that we haven't succeeded, or things go wrong, or plots or strategies of dark ones seem to get in the way of our victories or our timetables. Yet the key scripture is, what is that to thee? Follow thou me. What is that to thee? So when we say, what is that? What is the that? The that is the thing that we tend to react to or objectify or give energy to, that really doesn't require the energy of our attention, our focus, our reactivity, right? It doesn't really matter. What matters is our harmony, our oneness, our state of presence, and our ability to sustain the grace of God internally and externally. Now, Mother Mary says that we can't fake it. We either have it or we don't. So if there's an inner equanimity and an inner harmony, then naturally it will exude outward into our expressions, how we talk, how we treat people, how we live, move, and have our being. So since we can't fake it, you know, we have to do the internal work first for this to be true, real, lasting, and for it to be such that we can sustain that harmony on the outer part of, you know, in our outer selfhood. So we know people that are type A personalities who just seem to react to everything. And typically we don't like that, right? We don't like it when people don't treat us well. Well, we have to follow the golden rule and treat both others and ourselves well so that we can maintain that harmony, that equanimity. So it starts with the golden rule. Consider your words before you say them, and even your thoughts before you think them, because thoughts are vibrations and realities, and thoughts go out and have an impact on others. So whether you're thinking of, you know, now we can use that in a positive way. Our positive thoughts have beautiful vibrations, and these create the equanimity, the harmony, the peace that we desire. And that is emotional intelligence. We use our emotions, energy and motion, wisely, right? We choose wisely how we emanate, how we project, how we are. And so if we as a community, as a big spiritual family, choose to master this dynamic, this equation, it will most beautifully and naturally draw the right spirits, the right souls to our community, who also have a greater level of divine emotional intelligence, who can then work with us to grow not just the movement, but grow the ambience of divine love that we are a part of, this mystical union of our hearts with God. So when we practice the presence, Mother Mary says, we are practicing emotional intelligence because our presence is perfect. Our presence is very intelligent and emotionally stable. So we require the intelligence of our divine Christic mind, the mind of Christ, the mind of Buddha, living and moving through us to sustain the emotions in balance. If we don't have a Christic mind, we have great emotions, we have great love, yet the mindfulness is not there, then there can be a little bit of erratic energy in our emotional body. Mother Mary says, watch this, as we know, during the biorhythms of life, especially at the full moon, when the moon pulls on our emotional body. So that is a time when a lot of eruptions in the emotional bodies of the earth and of mankind and of even chelas or disciples can occur. So we have to be more cautious and more aware at those times. And also the low ebb, you know, the new moon. Now we may think that that's easier to sustain the emotional intelligence there, and it can be. Yet sometimes it's like a flip-flop where it's a new cycle coming, the new moon. It's like, okay, we don't see the moon at all in the sky. It's completely blacked out by the earth's shadow, and that's a good time to plant. So it's also a good time to lay seeds of light, of this emotional love, divine intelligence everywhere in our world, in our life, in the lives of our loved ones, in our community. So emotional intelligence is this byword of the initiate who has a balanced threefold flame, who has a developed Christic or Buddhic mind that's very thoughtful and caring and careful. And when we all vibrate together in this divine emotional intelligence state, everything will hum and go better because there's not this erratic energy field that somehow one or more of us have tied into, which the force can project, the dark spirits, to try to trip us up or make us be in a reactive mode, right? So I think we all know this truth. We all know this teaching. We know it internally. All this is a reminder. Yet it's something that we can consider. And the word heart stream is a perfect compound word that most radiantly expresses emotional intelligence. When we are streaming love from our heart, we are in that stable, emotionally positive and intelligent state, right? So we are heart streamers. We're all heart streamers in the heart center movement and community. And all light bearers really are. They may not use that term, but we use it. It's a beautiful concept, heart stream. We're streaming in a beautiful rendition our gifts of divine love that we share with humanity. So this is the primary teaching she desired to share today, and now we'll field any questions that disciples may have.